Hello and welcome to this video tutorial on how to create and enable macro features within Microsoft Word 2007. Macros are a great way to automate your work in Microsoft Word. The options for creating a macro are on the Developer tab of the ribbon. By default, Word 2007 doesn't display the options for creating a macro. To display the Developer tab, click the Office button and select Word Options. Click the popular button in the left side of the dialog box. Select Show Developer tab in the ribbon and click OK. The Developer tab will appear to the right of the other tabs on the Words ribbon, as you can see here. There are two ways to access the Record Macro button. On the ribbon, select View tab and click Macros. This is one way in which you can access your macros. The other way is by clicking the Developer tab. This is recommended as it has more functions. Now you're ready to get started creating your macro. Open the Developer tab and click Record Macro in the Code section. Word's Record Macro dialog box will appear and you can name and describe your custom macro. You have also options for creating shortcuts to your macro. A macro is a set of tasks that can be performed by pressing a shortcut key or by clicking the Quick Access Toolbar button. I will demonstrate all these features during this tutorial. For the first example, we will insert a logo. Enter a name for the macro in the macro name box. I'll call it Insert Logo, so it's relevant. The name you choose can't be the same as the built-in macro, otherwise the built-in macro will be replaced with the one you create. Use the Store in Macro box to select the template or document in which to store your macro. To make the macro available in all documents you create, select the normal .m template. Enter a description for your macro so you can identify the macro. If you do not want to create a button or shortcut key, click OK, but we will be creating a button for this example. Word lets you create a button for your custom macro on the Quick Access toolbar. However, Word doesn't allow you to design a custom button no more. To create a Quick Access button for your macro, click Button on the Record Macro box. This will open the Customize Quick Access toolbar options. Specify the document in which you would like the Quick Access toolbar button to appear. Select All Documents if you want the button to appear while you're working on any document in Word. In the Choose Command Form dialog box, select the macro and click Add. To customize your button appearance, click Modify. This is where you can choose any symbol that you wish to represent as your macro. I'll choose a flag. Enter a name for the macro in the macro name box. The name you should choose cannot be the same as the built-in macro, otherwise the built-in macro will be replaced with the one you create. Click OK. Now you can see that the logo and the text has been modified. Click OK. After you select your macro options, Word will automatically begin recording the macro. You can use keyboard shortcuts to perform the actions you would like to include in the macro. You can also use the mouse to click buttons on the ribbon and dialog boxes. However, you cannot use the mouse to select text. You must use the keyboard navigation arrows to select the text. Note that everything you do will be recorded until you click Stop Recording in the code selection of the Developer ribbon. Now we will insert the logo. So click Insert, Picture. This is my logo that I will insert. Click that and insert. When you insert an image using a macro command, it will not let you resize the image. However, we will be able to resize this after we have stopped the macro. So go back to the developer tab and click stop recording. Now the macro has stopped recording, click macros and you will be able to see the insert logo macro name. So if you delete the logo and click on the quick access toolbar, if you highlight over it, it will say insert logo. Click on this and my logo will reappear. As the image is quite large, resize it and use the format tools so it's text wrapped. Text wrapping is tight, so it will be able to move. Click home. To save, click the office button and click save as. Select the save as type and click Word macro enable template. If you do not save it as a Word macro enable template, the macros will disappear. Save. Thank you for watching how to create and enable macro features in Word 2007.